I'm going to really quickly show you how to fix the spelling errors, the typo errors, any mistakes that you make in your writing, and it's going to be done really quickly using this AI prompt. I think this is the AI prompt that I use more than any other AI prompt I probably use every day, and it is a custom one that I have made. So if we read through it here, here in the background, I've got an article draft selected, and it says to look at the text in the triple quotes, that's down here, and point out any spelling errors or typos. I tell it that grammar mistakes are okay as long as the writing sounds good. And that's because I like to do lots of things I realized after trying this that are technically grammatically incorrect, but I call them stylistic. And so I don't want them pointed out as mistakes. And then I, of course, tell it to make its best effort. That's something I usually include in my AI prompts. And then I have it list out the mistakes with the original text, and then what the fixed text should look like. And if you see, I give it an example down below. It's like the original incorrect text and then the fixed text. Do not include any style recommendations under any circumstances. I had to be very direct about that because it kept trying to give me style recommendations. Only list something if it's an actual error. And then I say, do not list the full original text in the fixed text. Instead, just show the incorrect text and what the corrected text should be. I know that sounds kind of jumbled, but basically what it kept doing is it would give me way too much context, and then I kept having to read through multiple sentences just to find the error. I find that this is a lot easier. So that's what the actual prompt is. I set it up as a custom prompt. If you're using Reflect, which is the tool I'm in here, it's really great for saving prompts like this, and you can run it right in your notes. Just click clone, give it a new name, you can edit it, and then click save. I'm not going to save that one because I've already done this. Okay, so let's give it a try and see how it works. So here, I've just selected this whole article. It's an article draft I'm writing on the indie hardware revolution. And I'm just going to pull up that custom prompt, list spelling and typo errors. And gonna run. Cool, so it found a couple. So let's see, it found three. So one looks like a missing M on the word simple. The second one is actually something I unfortunately do a lot. It's, I forgot the apostrophe, or I guess I'm mixing up the possessive and the conjunctive. Is that the right word? I am not a grammar person. This is why we have AI to do this. And then this is even a small one. Like, I used a lowercase d and it should have been a capital D. So in this case, honestly, what I would do is probably just go through and, do them from memory because there's only three. But maybe if you have a lot of them and there's like 10, I would just click copy. I don't want to click replace because that would replace my article with just these recommendations. You could also click insert, but I kind of like to do the copy. And then if I want, I can just put them at the top there. And then I can just control F them. So simple, I can make that then simple. So that one actually might be kind of hard because... there might be a few of those. So maybe it is something. Yeah, that was the wrong one. Maybe I should make sure the other ones are right. But, you know, I can go through and just make sure, since I know that's something that I've done frequently, that it's the right one. And then 3D, I can just go, go through until I find the one that I missed the capital on. Yep, there we go. Okay, so now I've taken those out and fixed those. Let's now, select the whole article. And... see what it finds. Cool. So this is actually a good reason of why I have it list them. This time I actually ran it on the whole thing. So the article draft up top, that's a tag. That's fine. It's going to ignore this. And then cherry going to cherry. I'm not saying cherry. And so that's actually a good reason of why I use the listing prompts versus if you saw, there's a system prompt that says to fix the spelling and grammar. And that's kind of nice, but it rewrites the whole article for me. So if you want to really trust AI, you can use that. And then it will basically run this on the whole prompt. And then I can just click replace at the end and I don't actually have to go in and fix them. But I don't trust it that much, mostly because my writing style is so kind of quirky. And I do lots of intentionally incorrect things that are more stylistic. And so I just don't trust it to kind of be, you know, like a grammar teacher and go through and fix it. So... that's why I use the fixed spelling, or sorry, list spelling and typos, I think it's called, but you can call it whatever you want. So I'll include the link to the spreadsheet that includes all the custom prompts, but I really recommend just adding this because at some point you'll need it, whether checking an email or an article. And yeah, then you can just have it list the errors and fix them quickly.